Hey creators, welcome to another episode of Elgato Flashback. This is the series which recaps everything going on in the world of Elgato, from exciting new hardware and software releases to marketplace plugins and assets, and so much more. In this episode, we'll look back at the custom Doom the Dark Ages drops, exciting new software tools, and a collection of brand new Stream Deck releases, both hardware and software. Starting us off in early May is Stream Deck 6.9, packed with quality of life changes. A few of my favorites are, first, the new open application action shows you a full list of all installed apps, making it really fast to get set up without needing to hunt down an app through your program files. The website action can now open a specific browser per action, open up links for work in Microsoft Edge, open up Netflix and YouTube in Chrome. The choice is yours. And the text action can now truly replicate hitting Ctrl-V or Command-V on your keyboard. Previously, the text action would simulate typing. You can, of course, still use the old method, which is perfect for sending commands in a game. Importing profiles is now also easier now that Stream Deck 6.9 will check for missing plugins and let you download them in one place. Super convenient. There's a ton more tweaks and improvements, so use Check for Updates in your Stream Deck app to try them out now. Next up in May was a limited edition custom drop with Doom the Dark Ages. Arm yourself with official Doom the Dark Ages gear like Stream Deck, Wave DX, and more. With incredible next-level customized designs and detailed textures that were forged in fire. You can find the full set available on our website, linked down below. Hurry though, as this is a limited edition. Later on in May, we had what we like to call Stream Deck Day, where we had four, yes, four announcements. First up was Stream Deck Scissor Keys, which takes the classic 15-key Stream Deck and adds an entirely new switch design, reminiscent of premium laptop keyboards, changing out the softer membrane feel for something with a more mechanical feel and feedback. It also sports a 1/4-20 thread on the back of it, making it the first Stream Deck you can mount right out of the box onto our multi-mount system. If you're a fan of the original switch design, don't worry, those will remain an option. Watch our full overview video of Stream Deck Scissor Keys linked down below to get all the details. What if you took the Stream Deck from your desk and brought it onto your computer's display? That's the idea behind Virtual Stream Deck. Instead of a tap, it's a click. Virtual Stream Deck, or VSD, supports all the same features like plugins, icons, profiles, and pages of physical Stream Decks, and adds in up to 8x8 layouts. Create limitless different VSDs to create purpose-built Stream Decks for each use. One for displaying weather and time, one for controlling tools in Photoshop, maybe one for holding your common text pastes. Virtual Stream Deck is a feature of Stream Deck 7.0 beta, and you can try it out today at elgato.com/downloads and then click on beta. To use Virtual Stream Deck, you will need a physical Stream Deck. Be sure to watch the overview with all the details of Virtual Stream Deck linked down below. We also had a ton of questions from you all and have a follow-up where I answer all your top questions. It's a great watch if you want to learn more about how to get more out of Virtual Stream Deck with some extra tips. Now, some of you out there love to tinker, and we've seen you add Stream Deck to all kinds of projects. And that's where our third announcement comes in, Stream Deck modules. These three modules represent our Stream Deck Mini, Stream Deck Mark II, and Stream Deck XL. You won't need to take the casing off of these, as Stream Deck modules are just what you need and nothing you don't. Ready to DIY and add them into your sim rig, control board, or smart home appliance. And they're available now on Elgato.com. Last up from Stream Deck Day was Network Dock. This small box adds power over Ethernet to your existing Stream Deck. In short, this means that instead of connecting your Stream Deck directly to your computer, you connect it to your wired network and control the computer from another room or on the opposite side of a building. Stream Deck Network Dock is aimed at the professional broadcast space. However, you can use it yourself with our own Stream Deck software when it launches. We closed out May by launching Elgato Explorer, your one-stop platform for everything Elgato. Here you'll find all kinds of resources, from how to get more out of your face cam to which capture card is right for you, and plenty of guides and walkthroughs for recording and streaming. All of it written by our technical staff, like myself. We have articles going live all the time. Check it out today by going to elgato.com/explore. Kicking off June was one of the most anticipated console launches in years. Yep, we're talking about Switch 2. And we're happy to confirm that our capture cards are fully compatible with Switch 2. Depending on your setup, there might be a couple extra settings you need to change. For that, we'll have our full setup video guide linked down below. It'll walk you through hooking everything up, adding your device to software, and lots of tips to get you up and capturing. Also, we are working on new firmware updates for Facecam and Facecam Neo so they can be used with your Switch 2. Be sure to follow our socials to be notified when that update is live. June was a super busy month for us, with a marathon of events. Elgato was at Infocom in Orlando, B&H Build Expo in New York City, VidCon in Anaheim, and Offkai Expo over in San Jose. It's always a highlight to interact with all of you, whether it's showing off a new feature or answering your creator questions. Later on in June, we announced Wavecast, and this is something I'm really excited about. Wavecast is an app that can send audio between two computers in real time, in perfect quality, and without having to mess with any cables. It's the dream solution that creators with dual PC setups have been wishing for. It does this by sending audio directly over your local network. For the best experience, the computers should be wired to your network though. So, okay, maybe one cable, but that doesn't count. During the beta phase, it's free to try out and use, and you can download it right now on Elgato Marketplace, linked down in the description. And of course, we would love to hear your feedback over on the official Elgato subreddit. And next up is a brand new capture app from us called Elgato Studio, which originally launched as a beta in May and has reached version 1.0 on July 1st. Elgato Studio is a next generation capture app for both Windows and yes, macOS. It's focused on responsiveness, performance, and simplicity. Connect your capture card, open up Elgato Studio, and begin recording in seconds. It's really that fast. And no need for separate tools to configure settings, it's all in there. So try out Elgato Studio for yourself by going to elgato.com/downloads. And of course, let us know what you think by leaving your feedback on our subreddit. We'll have that linked down below as well. More updates to Elgato Studio on the way. All right, that is a wrap for this episode of Elgato Flashback. As you heard, there is a lot going on here at Elgato, from events to products to new apps. Which of these updates or releases are you most excited about? Let us know down in the comments. And if you find these recaps helpful, why not give this video a like and subscribe to us here on YouTube so you won't miss any updates from us here at Elgato. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you on the next Elgato Flashback.